So Sara, you're representing some of the families involved in the disaster. You were here a few weeks ago. The place was in a heck of a state. How did you feel when you first saw it?
Well, I came down with one of the family members. She felt she just wanted to come here. She hadn't been here for a short while. And she just felt she needed to come to as close as she could get.
Yeah.
And she was really, really, really upset. She was more angry than anything because she felt she and the other families and the victims had been forgotten. That's the word she used. Obviously, we reported at her request to local media. And a group from the local community just impromptu came down the following night and did an amazing job clearing the site. And that was amazing. And, you know, thank you to them. It meant a lot to the families. But then to come down and see this morning, it's just, you can't help but smile.
Dave, there's been a lot of changes over the last couple of weeks since Sara first saw it.
Yes.
What's the publicity, the influencing thing that made you do things here?
What, in relation to the change in the flower beds? Mm. Well, the county became aware of the issues and how the family felt about this, and now we have the community volunteers down here with their coordinator putting in new flowers in all the bedding to last for the rest of the summer, which I think is a real major step forward.
And what do you think is going to happen now?
Well, I think that now that it's calm, it's sorted, it's tidy, it's pretty, it will give the families somewhere they feel they can now possibly come just to sit quietly, contemplate, remember. It's a calm place now, and that's what they wanted, somewhere they could bring their children, their family members, and just relax and think.
Dave, this is the first I've heard, by the way, about the volunteers. Tell us something about this.
Well, they have volunteers from right across the county that come together with the county council staff to work on projects like this throughout the county. The people we have here today come from places like Amberley or other places, Worthing and other towns in West Sussex. So they actually work on a regular basis to support the county in delivering the services to the local community.
It's almost a year since the disaster.
Yes.
What, anything planned yet by
yes.
the county, or is it nothing to do with the county?
No. Well, the county are still, obviously, the county are responsible for the bridge, which is a national monument, but they have the responsibility for it. But there's a number of things that we're doing. There will be a memorial service at St Mary de Hora Church in Shoreham at 11 o'clock on Saturday the 20th of August. That's a public event. People would be most welcome to go. The local priest, Anne Weisenecker, is away at the moment, but I know that she would welcome that support. And she's offering her support to the families, which I think is very valuable. As far as the event goes on the day concerned, the 22nd, there will be a minute's silence in all the council offices. The flags will be running at half mast. And there will be other events being run in conjunction with the County Council. Those are still being finalised, but we are talking to them about how we can coordinate that better.
Mm-hmm.
As far as the memorial goes, and I'm disappointed to hear the families think that things haven't moved on quickly enough, because when I was at the first meeting with the families to look at their views of what was required as a permanent memorial, and from there was drawn up a brief which was circulated to artists and people that do sculpture and things of that nature. The closing date for their submissions is in fact the end of next week. And there is a meeting planned with the families at the end of July to present all the offerings from the artists and to get them to select what they think is the most appropriate way forward. We're keeping in touch with the families through the force liaison officer, the family liaison officer with Sussex Police. And we and the County Council will be writing to them in the near future to keep them up to date with the latest arrangements.
How do you think the families are going to take to this?
Well, I spoke to three families this morning, and two of them have asked me just to put a couple of questions to you, if you don't mind.
Sure.
Both of them had said that they hadn't been made aware of the progress, so that's put that to rest. So thank you so much. We appreciate that. One of them has asked that maybe the road be closed on a day, or not for the whole day, but for a period that maybe some of the family members can go to the site and pay their respects.
This is the A27. Well.
This is the A27. Yeah. Now, that's just one person has been suggesting that. Now, obviously, I understand the logistics in that, and it's a bit of a nightmare. But that was one thing that she had suggested. She'd also said perhaps we could have in the notice board here photos and names of the victims. Mm-hmm. I think that would be something that's very much appreciated as well.
I mean, I see no problem with the latter of those. The other one, which is the responsibility of Highways England, mm-hmm. is something else. Now, I'd be more than happy to take that message back to Louise Goldsmith, the leader of West Sussex County Council, okay. and make her aware of the request.
Okay.
But I'm not sure whether that would actually end up in the road being
Of course,
closed.
Of course.
It may be possible to provide a safe area for them on that
yes.
day, but that's a discussion that will have to take place after
Certainly.
This meeting.
I mean, I know a lot of the families still won't use the road because obviously the emotions that it stirs up, so that was just one person's opinion.
Yeah.
But generally everything that they've asked me to raise I think has been answered just by me coming here and meeting with you today, so thank you so much for that.
Well, it's my pleasure. I just hope that the families, you know, get what they expect and we're able to support them in every way we can.
Absolutely.
Sara and Dave, thanks so much.